Hey everyone, John from ARTV. It is time for a review of the comeback album by American rock and electronic band LCD Sound System. It's called American Dream, and this is their first album in 7 years. This Is Happening was their last release. It was an album that saw them hitting the top 10 of the Billboard 200 for the first time, and I know I'm a bit late on getting my review of this out, but I wanted to make sure that I took my time and actually deciphered what was going on here. It's a long album. It clocks in at over an hour long, and it's their first album to ever hit number one on the Billboard 200 charts. So congratulations to them, and congratulations on making a great comeback in a world of mediocre ones. James Murphy is the mastermind behind LCD, and many people have praised him for kind of pioneering and bringing electronic and rock to the forefront. They're a band that were selling out arenas. Their final show obviously sold out, and now there's been some controversial comments by Murphy surrounding that, but I don't want to dive into that today. I just want to focus on the music. So what does this album sound like? What does it bring to the table? And why is it worth listening to? Well, I hope to quickly sum that up for you by telling you that it is a perfect fusion of kind of electronic, disco, ambient, and rock. There's a little bit of everything. And honestly, if you've been into LCD Sound System in the past, I know I kinda have, but I've only scratched at the surface. This just makes me scratch more, and there's an itch now, and I want to hear more from this band. I originally got into them because they had a song that appeared on the soundtrack of Burnout Revenge, believe it or not. That's what got me curious, got me wanting to hear more, and I sampled more songs from this band. Daft Punk Is Playing at My House was one of the initial tracks that I love from them, but for some reason, I never dove deeper into the discography, and I do want to do that after hearing this new album, American Dream. This is an album that kind of balances out growing older with giving commentary and almost advice to the world. This album is a steady wave of ideas, whether it be growing old or losing friends or commenting on something that he's seen in the music scene or society in general. There's things that aren't afraid to get political, but there's also some very personal moments here that open up about depression and losing a friend after such a long time, wishing that you had done more and had been there for them more throughout their lifetime. So it kind of is a dark album in places, and it definitely hits home a lot of these ideas. And I have to say, even though I've seen some mixed reviews from people in the music community here on YouTube, I'm definitely more inclined to loving this album overall as a whole. It's something that starts off with a more lighthearted moment like Oh Baby, which definitely seems like more of like a synth pop leaning like ode to like love and a relationship. And even though it is a bit familiar in terms of its lyrics, I really like the steady driving pacing that it has to it. And that's why so many of these songs work. If repetition isn't your thing and you're not on board with a lot of steady grooves just slowly building and giving that slow burn effect throughout the entire album, you might not be into this. Honestly, I understand that. And if it's not executed perfectly, then things are gonna get tedious quickly. But unfortunately, that's the case with other bands. Fortunately, here with LCD Sound System, that is not the case. And honestly, I think they do a great job of making all of these instruments and these builds just come together in a perfect way. And they do a great job of fusing genres. Since it is LCD Sound System, a lot of these songs are quite lengthy. And one of the longest ones here is also one of my absolute favorites. How Do You Sleep is that track. It clocks in at almost 10 minutes long. It's a crazy run, and it's one that gets very dark and almost ominous and brooding because it gets more in your face. The synthesizers get louder and louder. It almost seems like a horror suspense film soundtrack. I honestly don't feel like too many of these songs get stale as they go on. There's not a ton of weak elements or anything like that. Songs that stick out and you're just like, ah, I don't want to come back to that one, because there's something to gain from every single song here. Like Other Voices does a great job of kind of commenting on anxiety and depression that somebody might feel, whether it be as a musician or just as you grow older and feeling wary of your place in the world, or on Change Your Mind. That's something where I love the instrumental and the way that it kind of grips and doesn't let go throughout the entire runtime. And then you've got a more rocking song like Call the Police, one of the lead-off singles that we got from this thing, that definitely has a steady groove to it. I think the guitars have a great production to them. I love the way that they kind of gleam here. Reminds me of the 90s in a way. And you can see almost a U2 influence coming through on moments like that. Probably my top two favorites on this album come in the form of Emotional Haircut and Tonight. Latter of those getting a music video, being one of the singles, and I cannot resist this track. It seems like it's calling somebody out, but at the same time, it's almost a little bit sly and sarcastic with its undertones, and the entire groove of this song. It's a steady synthesizer that doesn't change all that much, but somehow, even though this is over 5 minutes long, it never loses its grip or its importance as a song. You're just steadily, just like kind of rocking out, grooving, and you're in the moment with Murphy and the rest of the band in this song, and I love getting lost inside that world. And then Emotional Haircut has some great lyrics on it. Honestly, it's something that I didn't really get until I read along on Genius, but once I sat there, started kind of paying attention and realizing what this song was about, I think I really like it, and it's one of the best that I've heard from LCD Sound System. Once again, with songs like Emotional Haircut, I can hear influences from great bands like U2, but I love the dark chaos that we hear in the instrumental of this song. Like, the bass starts to get a little bit crazy, and the guitars start to get a little bit of feedback from the pedals and the distortion there. And as the song goes on, you hear those backing vocals, Emotional Haircut. It's really actually quite captivating, and I love the use of just a variety of different approaches on this very song. I kind of lose focus while listening to some of the songs, like Oh Baby I suppose can lose me over time, and I Used To is one that I tend to start skipping a little bit more, and I'm ready for it to kind of get to the end so I can get to Change Your Mind and How Do You Sleep and obviously Tonight. I think that the album has its strongest runtime really between like tracks 5 all the way up to the first single and of course the title track from this thing, American Dream. That is a song that is very, very depressing. That alongside Black Screen are really the last two that I want to touch on. American Dream is one that definitely sees things kind of falling apart in Murphy's mind. It's something that you actually sit down and process this song, and you see that even though at its surface it almost seems a bit hopeful with the way that the synths and the guitars kind of seem like they're trotting forward, at the same time it seems like he's spiraling a bit, and I like how this plays out. Even though it's 6 minutes long, it really doesn't feel that at all, and it definitely justifies that runtime. Even if it isn't a top favorite for me, I definitely still appreciate this track. And then the closing moment is just a haunter, one that I see is definitely being about David Bowie. Obviously, fans are kind of theorizing that, oh, it might be about him and somebody else. I feel like this is definitely the personal friendship that he had with Bowie, and seeing him pass took his toll, and he's talking to the black screen. The title of the track implies that the night sky up at night, where could Bowie be up there? And he just kind of reminisces on how he wishes he had spent more time. You replied to my emails with short answers, and I always loved it. I lit up whenever I got a response from you. He loved talking about music and just life in general with Bowie. And I feel like there's a couple of other references packed into this very album, American Dream. You can definitely see how much of a toll that this took on Murphy. To wrap it up, this is a really solid effort. I was definitely surprised by it, and it makes me want to hear more by LCD Sound System. Congratulations again on that number one album. I doubt that they'll ever see this review, but if you do somehow, Murphy, keep it up. Everyone else, make sure you check out the album. There's a link to stream it in the description down below, along with more information about this record. Don't forget to drop a like on the review while you're here. And me personally, I'm going to give this a strong 4 out of 5 and say that this could have a modest replay factor. I could definitely see myself vibing out to this, especially on long late night drives. What did you think of LCD Sound System's comeback, American Dream? Sound off in the comments section down below, and if you're able to, please support me on Patreon. It's that top link in the description down below, or else there should be an annotation in the corner of the screen that'll take you directly there. If you want to see another electronic and rock review that I did, click right here, or another recent review right over here. All of my socials can be found in the description down below, and other than that, I'll see you very soon right here on ARTV.